Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. You'll have to excuse me, I forgot I was filming today and I put a leave-in conditioner in, so my hair's being conditioned. It's not greasy, so just ignore it. Kind of like just from here on down. Listen, today I want to talk about some of the best and worst products I've tried throughout kind of February, March. Products that I've been loving, products that I've been not liking so much. And I also want to hear your opinion about some of these products and some of these newer launches as well. As always, let's start off with a hit. So I have a story, right? I use an American shipping service to get products that are only sold in America over here in the UK. And this shipping service, Ship It To, lost one of my parcels and it was like in their warehouse for months and months. So I posted about, and the brand whose products I bought, Future Wise, whose products they lost, actually sent me the products. They're like, we'll send it out to you. I was like, thank you so much. But then the next day, maybe a coincidence after Instagramming about it, Ship It To were like, we found your parcel, it's on its way. And it literally arrived the next day. So I have been using this brand for a while now. I would say just over a month, maybe like a month and 2 weeks or something like that. So thank you, Future Wise, for stocking me back up as well. I've got your products over there and I'm so glad because I am going through these products. So these are kind of products all based on slugging. Now, slugging isn't just a trend. Yes, it's got this trendy name, but slugging has been around for ages. The act of putting an occlusive layer on to keep everything in. Marilyn Monroe, I think, is one of the earliest documented cases of slugging. And what Future Wise do is they do this kind of amazing slug boost. This is hydrating mist. They have a barrier repair moisturizer, looks like this, and then they have their slug balm, looks like this. And the reason I love these products is because they are in fact very, very simple, but it's everything you kind of want to do whilst you're slugging and kind of the whole point of slugging. So of course, hydration is a huge part of keeping your skin nice and healthy. This is hyaluronic acid in, polyglutamic acid, again, a really nice hydrating ingredient. Glycerin, again, everyone's preferred humectant, and then squalane as well, which is a really nice moisturizer without being too thick. So just a really nice hydrating mist. There's a few oils and extracts in here that I could do without, but honestly, my skin's had no issue with it whatsoever. The barrier repair moisturizer, again, the reason we slug really is to keep in all that hydration, and having an intact barrier is so important. Just like that, like one pump is enough. The slug cream, they say, has a vegan triple lipid complex in, which is fatty acids, cholesterol. This is like keeping your skin barrier intact. Again, part of the reason we want to slug is to keep everything intact, keeping all the hydration and peptides as well. And then their slug balm, think Vaseline, but a little bit more fancy, with occlusive plant-based oils and a lipid complex as well. Honestly, it's just a nice slugging balm. What I love about this one is it feels somewhat dry. So Vaseline still does a great job. CeraVe, that one still does a great job. This feels nicer on the skin. It feels less intrusive. It feels less oily. You put it on, your face doesn't still feel sticky and hot. You can sleep on your pillow without your face sticking to the pillow, you know? A really nice thin layer of this does such an amazing job at keeping everything in. And I've been using this pretty much every night, especially when I went to London. Whenever I go to London and use hotel water, my skin just gets red and blotchy and parched around my eyes especially. So it's vital. Like the last month, I've been trying to do whatever event comes my way, just trying to be more sociable. I had to have that. If I didn't have that, my skin was fucked. Like I had to have that in my bag. So yes, love that. Love that, love that, love that. It's just a nice basic slugging system. In good packaging. Let's move on to a shit. And I do feel really, I feel like I'm just shitting all over this brand all the time. But this is Conserving Beauty and this is their CU Cleansing Balm. I've used their dissolvable makeup wipes. Not for me, but I love that they have this melting technology, their Instamelt technology, where their makeup wipes just dissolve underwater. The same with their sheet mask. Again, not for me. It was just a load of oils. I thought cleansing balm made sense because literally they use oils. I said something really stupid. I was like, why can't they just replace their face mask with like a serum formulation, because it's water-based and you can't have that in a dissolving sheet mask. So it makes sense that they have to have oils, but it just doesn't feel right. It felt very much like cooking oil on the face. So they say that this has a whole host of vitamins, antioxidants, and essential fatty acids to help replenish and hydrate the skin. We got castor seed oil, cocoa seed butter, sunflower seed oil, coconut oil, candelia wax, and vitamin E. And honestly, it's not very nice. And I hate saying this because I love what they're trying to do. I feel so bad because I feel like I really want to like this brand, and that's why I keep buying their products and trying to review them. It's so windy outside, sorry if you can hear it. It's just horrible. It's just so bad. And this, do you know what this reminds me of? Is goose fat. You know when you cook your like roast potatoes in a bit of animal fat or put it on a turkey? I don't know. I don't cook. It feels like cooking fat. You put it on, it's a really nice texture in the actual jar, and then you bring it out and it's just those thick suffocating oils that you really have to work over your face to get rid of any makeup and sunscreen. It's not like an oil slick kind of oil, like what's that one I love, like the Sofimo or whatever it's called one. It's hard work. It's hard work to work around the skin. It takes a while to wash off because it feels so water repellent. It does just feel like cooking fat. And I went on Cult Beauty, which is where I got it from, and I should have looked at the reviews, because whilst it does have 4 5-star reviews, it has 3, 2, and 1 reviews. One person said, I really didn't enjoy this cleansing balm. The texture is lumpy and difficult to break down, to use, and very irritating on my eyes. I did feel like it left a film after washing off too. I don't agree that it's lumpy. It melted down very, very easily. But yeah, it felt like it had a film. It felt like it had an oily film that was really hard to get off. Someone else says, I really tried to like this cleansing balm, especially because of the ingredients, but this is one of the worst I've ever used. It does remove makeup, but leaves my skin dry and seriously irritates my eyes, even when I don't have mascara on. So Anne L says, not for me. I was really excited about this after reading the other reviews here, but I've had the opposite experience. People are finding it very, very drying, even with an oily T-zone. So I agree, it's not the nicest cleansing balm. Here's the thing, is like Conserving Beauty are doing a great job at what their brand is about. And I love it. I'm glad I've tried the products. And these are kind of like things where, you know, if you really, really do care about saving the world, not that I don't, but if you really care about the waste and all that within the cosmetics industry, these are probably things you can look past, but they are just a bit too wrong. Do you know what I mean? I feel like they're just using, they've got this one formulation of oil that they're using in all their products and thinking, how can we just use that oil blend differently? I did try and film a video last year. I spent 6 months trying different zero waste brands. And again, I feel so bad for saying this, but they were all terrible. And it's because I feel like people aren't, you know, the investment isn't there for these smaller brands who are really trying to make something of zero waste products. And I feel like there's so much they can do, but someone needs to invest in it, you know? Maybe someone higher up. I don't know how business works. But my issue with them is that, first of all, none of them really did what they promised to do. They were all in these kind of like rub on your face square, you know, like Lush soap kind of packaging. They all had essential oils in. They all had the same ingredients. They all smelled, you know, like a candle shop kind of thing. And all of them were extremely irritating. And I don't know why there's this link between zero waste and essential oils and a clean movement, I guess is what it is. Conserving Beauty seem to be very different from that, and I love that they've come up with this Instamelt technology. I just wish there was something a little bit more user-friendly, because it's all great having this kind of like ethos, like highly commendable and respectable, but the products have to be at least good, you know? It's tough. My next hit is going to be the La Roche-Posay Cicaplast B5 Serum. So this is their Cicaplast in the serum form, obviously all about barrier repair. And they say that this leaves a thin barrier-like layer on the skin, basically helping to protect anything coming out of your skin or going in. And then vitamin B5 is in here to take care of transepidermal water loss, increasing hydration. And you know what? It's nice. It is extremely hydrating. It's like a nice hydrating serum within itself. And it is very, very light. And if it creates a barrier, I can't feel it. It's very, very nice. Again, this has been great at kind of like just soothing my dry, irritated skin from what I presume is like dry, hard water. Not a surprise I like it so much because I love the Cicaplast range. Here's my issue. Look how shit that packaging is. The packaging is absolutely awful. It's just like not put on properly sticker. And this is from a PR box where they usually make a little bit more effort. But also, this lid barely screws on. It's got the thickest pipette that's so difficult to squeeze at the top. And then when you put it back in, you have to try your hardest to not leak it. Can you see that? Like leak it around the edges because the pipette is so thick. It is some of the worst packaging I think I've ever used on a serum, in a serum. But the product does my skin so much good. I'm happy to look past it and just deal with the fact that I have to do what feels like a game of operation every night, trying to get the pipette back in the bottle. But I would really recommend it if you really just want a barrier-friendly, recovering, hydrating serum, which honestly everyone can do with at least once a day. This is the one to go for. On that same note, my next shit is the La Roche-Posay Eye Serum Anti-Wrinkle Concentrate Repairing Replumping Pure Hyaluronic Acid Vitamin B5 Caffeine Serum. We all know caffeine is a great ingredient under the eyes. Hyaluronic acid, great for plumping, whatever, whatever, whatever. I don't even want to talk about it because I don't understand their thought process. So here we go. A nice pipette with this kind of like really nice new thing that people are doing with that rollable on the bottom feels amazing on the under eyes, really giving you this like awakening, kind of like brightening, cold to the touch under eye cream. This is the stickiest eye cream I've ever used. And I put eye cream above here, just a thin layer, and around here. I don't know if you watched a previous video of mine, I don't know what one I used it in, but my eyelids were sticking together. I can open or close my eyes properly. They were literally, I close my eyes, do this, so it's all coated here. Then I'd open my eyes and my eye folds would just stick together. So my eyes were like this. It was terrible and the stickiness doesn't go. So any eyelash I got was stuck to my under eye throughout the day. It felt like I had conjunctivitis. Like that's how bad it was at one point. I thought my eyes were sticking together. I was like, what is going on? Because obviously eye cream can travel a little bit as well. It's just the most horrible formulation I think I've ever used in an eye cream. But I still trust La Roche-Posay with their other products. That hasn't put me off trying a lot more. So this is still fairly new. I've been using this about 2.5 weeks when filming this video. And this is the moisturizer from Skin Rocks. This is Caroline Hirons' brand. This is the face cream. This is a fragrance-free version, but they do one with fragrance in, which I'm told is like a little bit citrusy. I don't mind fragrance in my skincare, obviously. And that is the only difference between the product, you know? So on the website, they say that this is a daily moisturizer to give you instant hydration, help promote long-term skin health and radiance, including pro-vitamin D3 for improved barrier function, ceramide to help keep your skin hydrated, hyaluronic acid for hydration, squalane to help hydrate your skin as well. Again, I love squalane to help moisturize without being sticky and greasy. And then a blend of superfruits for antioxidants. And I have been loving this because I'll be honest, I'm not into my super dewy skin at the moment anymore. I actually find that more recently, super dewy skin kind of exaggerates the redness of my rosacea. So it's trying to find a moisturizer that gives my skin a lot of hydration, but doesn't come with that super dewy glass skin look that we all kind of like, we all do still really love. This has the perfect balance of making your skin feel like it's hydrated, nourished and cared for and moisturized, giving you a normal, natural glow. And by natural glow, I mean not like glowing, just like how healthy skin looks without being too much. And that's what really for me does make this like a universal moisturizer that everyone can enjoy. Because I do feel like a lot of brands lead by trend at the moment. So a dewy moisturizer has very much been in for like 5 years, but not everyone enjoys that. But the moisture and the hydration that you get from this lasts so long as well. This is one of those moisturizers that if you're oily, I'm combination oily, a little bit dry, I can use this during the day and I'm both happy on my oily skin, my dry skin. I could use this at night and wake up not feeling dry as well. So it's often hard to find a moisturizer that does both care for your skin throughout the day without being too thick, but at night without being too light as well. And this is literally just a perfect balance. When you first put it on, you're like, oh, this is going to be too thick. Like this is a thick one, which for someone with an oily T-zone, I don't necessarily want to use in the morning because it has this like thick whipped kind of texture to it. But then you put it on and it kind of rubs down into this, like, not watery at all. It's not watery, but almost like this just thicker than gel cream texture that effortlessly rubs into the skin. I'm really, really enjoying this. I've made a star on the oil, sometimes as an alternative to the moisturizer, just to try it out, you know? So I'll keep you updated on that one, but yeah, I'll be honest, I don't expect anything less from Skin Rocks. Okay, here's my last shit, and this one you probably already saw coming, but I recently tried the Supergoop Glow Screen SPF 30 in one of my videos. I think Supergoop do good sunscreen, very good sunscreen. I do think a lot of their products are a little bit silly, like sunscreen serums and just kind of these steps that you don't really need. I get serum weight sunscreens, it's just a light sunscreen, but I do think there are a lot of things that Supergoop do that aren't really necessary. The glow screen sounds like a nice idea, a slightly tinted sunscreen with almost like this pearlescent sheen to it. So I guess it's meant to give you like this almost like bronze sun-kissed look, which I honestly was really up for trying. My issue with this is that pearlescentness to the product shows up every single bit of texture you've ever had on your skin, in my personal experience. Dryness around your nose, you're fucked. Pores in your cheeks, fucked. The pores that showed up on my forehead, you know, I thought I should retire. This showed up every single bit of texture and was so unflattering that I was just like, oh, this, I want to take this off immediately. I'd rather go out and burn than have to wear this. And listen, I was tasting this for days. I know it sounds really silly. I double cleanse at night if I've had a sunscreen on. I was tasting Supergoop sunscreen for days. And I don't know why. Maybe it was stuck in my facial hair. I don't know why. It was such a horrible looking product. In my monitor, I was like, okay, it just looks like a normal sunscreen. It felt like a normal sunscreen. Stung my eyes a little bit. But you know, a lot of sunscreens do. It just varies per person. But this was, I just couldn't believe how horrible my skin looked. It looks so bad. It looked like I got into my mum's makeup bag and started playing with a bronzer as a child. And I was like, just doing this. It was just, it's just not for me. I know a lot of people like this one. So maybe if you have very good skin, you're gonna love this. So there we go. Those were my hits and shits for the month of March. Let me know if you love or hate any of these in the comments down below. And let me know what I should try next in the comments as well. You can watch some more product reviews here, some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.